For me, the steeplechasing performance of the decade was by a horse in Crisp who didn't even win the race in question. This was the 1973 Grand National, and coming down to Beecher for the second time, well, I've never seen a horse so far in front. Remember, he was carrying 12 stone, he was giving £23 to a horse called Red Rum, who jumped the one before Beecher there in second place. He simply jumped from fence to fence. Peter, have you seen anything like it?
No, I must say, that was really spectacular. I think going back some time before your time, Julian, Prince Regent, he gave me a similar sort of thrill, but this was something really quite unbelievable.
Well, the end of this race is almost too sad to behold. Of course, Chris was caught. He was caught and beaten by the great Red Rum in a time of 9 minutes, 1.2 seconds, almost 20 seconds faster than the previous fastest Grand National record time. Surely one of the great Grand Nationals of our time, and that, of course, was the start of the legend of Red Rum.
Yes, the start climaxed in 1977 by this little horse who, I know it's an overworked word, charisma, but he really has it. He's a great showman, a great personality. He rises to the occasion, he responds to the crowd, Red Rum, and I think what made, for me anyway, that 1977 national such a memorable one from a commentator's point of view was the foreknowledge that he carried such a tide of public sympathy with him, and the fact that in this national he set out against 41 opponents, conceding weight in varying degrees to every one of them. And this is how it went.
As they come to the raw fence of the national, and Red Brown with a tremendous chance of winning his third national, he jumps it clear of Jets down by. He's getting the most tremendous cheer from the crowd. They're winning it home now. The 12-year-old Red Brown, being preceded only by loose horses, being chased by Church down by. Our catcher has moved into third.
Became more than a racing legend. He proved himself to be almost human, and that perhaps the most emotional moment of the decade. Well, there have been so many other great horses we haven't had time to mention. A Legend, the Minstrel, Dunfermline and Highclere, and of course Troy, as we mentioned, but a few. So many horses to choose from. But Peter, can I put you on the spot and ask you your horse of the decade?
Well, I'd be very hard put to it Najinsky, I think, Julian. And there's no doubt about one thing, that the horse that gave you most pleasure was Tumbledown Wind. The horse that gave me most pleasure was Atiba. The horse, I think, whose presence made the most profound impact upon me, I would have to say, thinking objectively, speaking objectively,